Hi, I'm Steve Sexton. Welcome to Hapkido Ultimate Self-Defense Techniques. Okay, now we're going to go over some basic punching strikes. And I'm going to show you the posture and exactly how to do it, where to hit on the hand, how the body should be. Let's start off with the stance. Knees should be slightly bent. If your leg is straight, it's easy to break should somebody kick it, break the knee. You want it bent. You're also ready to move when it's bent. Okay? You want to stand at a slightly 45 degree angle. When you're using hands, you should be within hands distance. Other than that, you know, you should be kicking. So if you're close enough to punch, you should be punching. You're too far away, you should be kicking. So all of this stuff is done within arm's reach. Now, 45 degree angle, hands up about chest level. The reason for that is you're about halfway between the groin area and the face to block. You can use either hand to go either way. Now, let's start off with a jab. When doing the jab, from here, you want to throw it in a straight line from the chest, like this. You're going to be hitting with these two knuckles right here. The reason for this is, when you make a fist, look at my fist. You notice how the thumb covers these two fingers? These two fingers are supported and they're very tight. You hit with these two knuckles. If you don't, oftentimes you can get what they call a boxer's fracture. A lot of people just swing and hit, and they hit over here with these fingers. These fingers give because they're not supported by the thumb. They're not strong at all, and you end up breaking this bone in your hand. This is what's called a boxer's fracture. Stay away from that and always try and hit with these two knuckles. So, you're at a 45 degree angle, straight. When you throw a jab, you don't want to just do it with all arm. You want to get a little bit of power out of it. So you lean into it, push off of your rear foot, bend your forward knee. That way you can go through your target and then come back. Always recoil punches. Never just leave them out there and let them drop. Strike and come back. Strike and come back. All right, we're going to move into a reverse punch now. Stance would be the same, about a 45 degree angle. You've already seen the jab. You lean into it, hitting with those two knuckles. Come back. Reverse punch comes in a straight line also. Hand exactly the same way. Thrown from the chest in a straight line. Like this, same thing, hitting with these two knuckles. Make sure everything's in a straight line. A lot of people punch wrong and the wrist is like this. You hit something solid, you're going to break your wrist. Needs to be in a straight line with your arm. Okay? Strike. Okay? From here, jab, right hand. Now, really strong punch this is. Rarely are you going to knock anybody out with a jab. So it needs to be followed with something. When you hit somebody with a jab, just gives you enough time, gets their attention to throw this one. If you just throw this one without the jab, it's like you can see it coming forever. You don't want that. You want to go one, two. And when you throw this right hand here, or left if you're a southpaw, you always want to pivot the hips, put the body weight behind it. Throw it in a straight line. Notice how my feet pivot. The hips go into the punch. You don't want to just go like this. There's nothing behind it. Put that body weight into it like this. Recoil and come back. Okay, so when applying these techniques, what are the target areas? Let me demonstrate. Depending on who you've got in front of you, I want you to realize the lower you hit somebody on the head, the easier it is to knock them out. That's why they call this the button. You hit them up here, it's much harder to knock somebody out than if you hit them here. Okay, this is really important. The dynamics of a big guy, he's got a chest like this, arms like this. You don't want to hit him in the arms and the chest. You're not going to do any good. You need to hit him where he's vulnerable. Accuracy is really important. Okay? Let's start off with a jab. He's like this. I'm like this. Looks like, he's relatively safe. You want to be out of range. But just by a little bit of bend of the front knee and leaning in, now I've got some distance to hit him. And he's been hit. You want to hit him on the button. Should it be lower? You don't want to hit him in the chest if he's a big guy. You don't want to hit him in the arm if he's big. You want to hit him where he's vulnerable, where there's no meat or a vital organ, like, let's say, solar plexus. Straight in. let's say, a rib, where there's not much muscle by the rib, and back.
Okay, the next one I'm going to show you is a palm heel, striking this way. You will see this one periodically throughout this video. I'd like to pay close attention. I've used this one several times. It works, but it's important that you hit right with this and in the right area. This one, basically, I would throw it only to the head, the jaw area, or maybe a little higher on the head, depending, but lower, remember, the lower the better. Now, same stance, 45 degree angle. When this is done, the body posture is a lot like your jab. Lean into it, go through. But when you strike, open your hand, bend this joint, slightly bend the fingertips. When you strike like this. And what you want to hit is not everything here. Too much meat, a lot of muscle here. You're going to hurt yourself. I've done this before by accident, not hitting right. When you strike, you want to hit with this bone right here. Smaller, it's like hitting somebody like this. So when you strike, hit like this. Lean into it, strike. Recoil, come back. Okay, so the target area is anywhere on the head, lower the better. Jaw is ideal. So from here, he's out of range, a little bit of bending of the knee, leaning in, strike with this bone. Look at the hand, slightly bent fingertips. Thumb bent, that tightens everything right here. Strike, like this. Recoil and come back. Strike, come back. Okay, now we're gonna go over some of the blocking techniques used in this video. Basic blocks, but very important. Now, most of these, if you'll recall, you get out of the line of power. It's a matter of moving to the side, out of that line here. So, let's start it off like this, 45 degree angle. First one, there's a punch or a kick, whatever it might be, coming at you. Footwork is important. Remember, you've got to move to the side. A little bit of lean, then this hand is going to come up and block the technique in that direction. You're moving around it. As it's coming at you, move, block. This is where you want to block. Then, should you be doing any type of throwing technique after that, you can use your hand to grab. See? So, watch again. Move out of the way. Block to the side. Finished. Okay, now notice the flow of this block. As I move to an angle, it's coming across my face and then blocked. So this is protected should he be able to change direction. Block, and then do your technique, whatever it might be. Move to the side. Block. Right here, and then back. Okay, now let's look at the application of this block. Watch carefully. As the punch comes at you, remember, move to the side. This comes across my face. Block right here. And remember, should you want to go into another technique, you block here, then you can grab and do something else. But timing is crucial. If you move too soon, remember, if he starts to punch, if I start to move too soon, he can recorrect and come over here. He's got to be in motion. Move, block. Okay, one of the other blocks that you're going to see frequently is an upward block. When you're in your stance and a punch comes at you, this time you're not going to move to the side, you're going to get underneath that punch. So from here, blocking with the same part of the arm, right here, you're going to block upward, straight upward, like this, above your head. It's got to be above head level. If you block only to here, that punch is going to come through and hit you. So you've got to block above the head. So from here, straight up. Here, straight up like this, and back. Okay, in applying this block, let's look at the technique here. You know I'm a big advocate of moving at angles. Sometimes that's not possible. So, when you're in that kind of situation, and somebody's coming straight at you and you have to block, which is the one I'm about ready to show you, remember, you want to hurt them right away. You can't have somebody coming at you, they'll run you over. Now, you're standing here, as the punch comes, upward block, like this. Blocking with this part of the arm, A little bit of look under your arm so you can see what you're going to hit next. Maybe it'll be the leg, maybe it'll be the face. Who knows? Come back, let's try it again. Block up, above the head, and back. Okay, this next block. If you recall, I've told you, if something is coming around, you either want to move into it or in the direction it's going. This particular block we'll use against a hook that's coming around. And I'm going to show you how to move into it. You're going to block with the same part of the arm right here. But as it's coming around, you're going to move into it, putting you in a better situation to combat this. So as he throws his hook that's coming around, I want to come inside and block with this part of the arm, but I want to kind of shuffle. I don't want to stay here. I want to get inside of it. So as it's coming, I want to get in. Now at this point, I can either hit him with that palm strike, reverse punch, knee, anything like that. But remember the strikes that I've been showing you. Palm here, reverse punch, knuckles. So as it's coming, shuffle in, get inside of it. Don't stay outside. One more time, watch. As it comes around, shuffle in, strike or strike, and then get out of there. Okay, now let's watch this technique directly at the camera. I'm standing at my 45 degree angle, hands about chest level. This hook is coming around at me like this. His target area is right where I'm at now, so I want to get inside of that. Shuffle into it. Block with this bone, and then your strike is optional. You can strike here, you can strike here, and then get out. Okay, Phil here is going to demonstrate some of the basic Hapkido kicking techniques that could save your butt in a realistic fight. They're absolutely not too much different than most of your systems, but you're going to use them all the time. You always rely on your basics. Okay, we're going to start off with a front kick. Front kick comes straight at you. It's done with the ball of your foot like this, and it snaps and recoils. Remember, always recoil your kicks. If you don't, you just snap it out there and let your leg drop. Something like that is tailor-made for a Hapkido man that'll grab it and use it to throw you. So, snap and recoil. He's going to demonstrate the front kick. Go ahead. That's the way it works. Okay, now face me. It's usually done about midsection. Okay, kick. Notice how he extends his hips, giving you more penetration. Try one more time. Excellent. That's the front kick. Okay, the next kick is called a side kick. This is done with what we call the knife edge of the foot, the side here. Rather than hitting with the flat part of your foot, covers too much mass. The less pounds per square inch, the more impact, the harder it's going to hit, the more it's going to hurt. You want to hit with what we call the knife edge. He's going to demonstrate it cross-stepping, utilizing the front foot, stepping into it and doing it. Okay, go back, try it again, fast. Okay, now at me. Take a fighting stance. Switch. This kick can go anywhere from the knee to the face, anywhere in between. In fact, he can do two or three of them in a row if he wants. But we're just going to do it about right here, right now. This is what it looks like. Go. Same thing. Extend those hips. A lot of penetration. One more time. Okay, the next basic kick is called a roundhouse kick. A lot of snap from the knee down. Okay, it comes around, not in a straight line. Around. This kick can also be done anywhere from the leg, midsection, head. Anywhere. Either side. Demonstrate. One more time. Okay, try me. Go. Good. One more high. Excellent. Okay, the next kick we're going to demonstrate is called a spinning back kick. It's basically a lot like your side kick, only it's done from the rear leg and you turn and kick in a straight line. This one can go anywhere on the body also, from the knee to the midsection to the face. This one, to demonstrate, we're going to show about waist level, straight. Okay, the way this is done is he takes a fighting stance and pivots, turns and looks over his shoulder. Then the rear leg is going to kick in a straight line. Go. And then down. Notice the recoil. That's an important factor there, that recoil. Try it again. One motion. Pivot, turn and look. Kick. Ha! Very good. Now show it towards me.
Sir.
All right, fighting stance. Pivot. Kick. Chop. Good. Good kick. Try again. Pivot. Go. Excellent. Okay, one more. And that's the spinning back kick. Okay, these are four Hapkido kicking techniques that I'd like you to train hard and practice with. Do them over and over and over. Repetition is the secret to success. Don't just look at it once, try it once. Do it right, over and over and over. That's what's going to make you good.
Okay, in the street, the typical person is not going to know how to fall down. And if he does fall, he's probably going to break something or hurt something. When you're working with your training partner, what you want to do is make sure that when you fall safely. And that means you're not going to be hitting any kind of joint or bone. So I'm going to show you several different falls and just correct and talk about the correct ways to fall. So the first one we'll do is called a forward fall. So anytime someone pulls you forward and you're going off your feet, you're going to need to land stomach forward. So in order to do this, what you want to do is keep your arms bent rather than straight so that you don't hit your elbow or your wrist or hurt your elbow. So you're going to keep your arms bent in the form of a triangle formed with your hand. And as you land, you want to make sure that the side of your head is turned to the side, that it's not facing down where you're going to strike your chin. So basically, let me just show you. From here, you're going to bend down. Okay, you're going to lean forward. And as you come down, you're going to be hitting your forearms like this. And then you're going to be landing, turning your head one side or the other. It really doesn't matter. You want to keep your knees off the ground. Okay, we're going to do it again, but we're going to look at it from the side. We want to make sure that we don't strike our knees, that we don't strike any bony parts of the body. And in order to do this, we have to lower ourselves down first. So we're going to lower ourselves down and kick out our feet and lie forward in the way that a piece of paper falls flat when you drop it. So your body is like this. You're going to lower yourself down. You're going to kick your feet out, and you're going to move your arms forward and land horizontally on the ground using the triangle and turning your head to the side. So it's going to look like this. Come down and like this. Your knees should be off the ground. You should be on the forearms and not the bones of your hand. Your head should be off the ground and turned to one side or the other. Okay, the next fall we're going to look at is in the situation of somebody's taking you down on your side. For example, if you're in a headlock and you're going to be falling on your side, or any time when someone's throwing you over the leg. In order to do that, you need to land laterally, and you're going to be falling on either side of your leg by bringing your leg up in front and bending down. And as you bend down, you're going to bring your arms up. Same idea. You don't want to strike any of the bony parts. You want to be hitting just with the flesh, the forearm. You're going to lower yourself down. You're going to fall along the side of your leg, and you're going to make a slapping noise. Okay? So I'm going to lower myself down and flat. Notice that I'm not striking my elbow. I'm hitting with the forearm part. Okay, with the palm, my hands up so that my shoulder's up and I'm not hitting my spine, and that I'm falling pretty much on my back muscles and my butt. Okay, the last one we're going to do is a back fall. This is when you're tripped backwards or you're thrown backwards or pushed. Basically, what you want to make sure you do is that, again, you don't want to land on any bony parts. As you're falling down towards the ground, you're basically going to be landing on your rear end first. You're going to curl up in a ball slightly, and you'll be touching your shoulder blades,
your muscles, but not your spine. Okay, your arms are going to come up in front of you like this. There's several different options you have for it, but one of them will just be to bring your foot forward to lower your body down. The closer you are to the ground, the less the impact. Okay, from here, you're just going to stay curled in a ball. You're going to roll, touch your rear end, and then bring your feet up and slap. Okay, we're going to do this again, but from a side view. Again, the key points are you want to fall on the parts that are soft with muscle rather than on bone. And the key to doing this is lowering yourself to the ground before you fall, and also to stay curled and make sure that you slap to absorb the shock. Okay, so turning sideways, you're going to bring your foot in front. You're going to bend yourself down low, lean your body forward, cross your hands, go down to your rear, and slap.
Hi, my name is Steve Sexton. I'm a 6-degree black belt in the art of Hapkido. I've been involved in it 33 years. My student John Felpin is here. He's going to assist me today. We're going to teach you how to escape from wrist grabs. I want you to pay close attention, go get your sweats on, and let's get started. Hapkido has an array of grabbing techniques. You can be grabbed anywhere on the body, and there's a way to get out of it. One of the first things we're going to work on today is grabbing on the inside of the wrist. And it's done like this. He grabs my wrist. First thing you do is open your hand tight. Tight. That tightens all the muscles in the forearm, gives him a worse grip. I put my hand on top of his hand so he can't escape. Now, realistically, I might strike him first or kick him to loosen him up. But right now, we're just going to go through the technique, the technical end of it. So pay close attention. Hold his hand tight to your wrist. Bring it over on top of his wrist. Drop this to your belt and have a hold of his wrist. This hand goes just above the elbow. Apply pressure straight down to a center point right between your legs. And there he is. Okay. We're going to go over it again. Watch closely. He grabs the inside of my wrist. I open my hand tight, trap his hand so he can't get away. I bring this hand over on top of his wrist, grab his forearm, drop it to my belt. This arm is now just above his elbow. I'm now in what we call a horse stance for good balance, sideways to him, so he can't knee me in the groin or anything else. At this point, this never moves here. If he comes out here, he's got a lot of leverage to yank me around.
Stays tight, good balance. I apply pressure down to the ground at right between my legs. Now he goes. Now he's helpless. Not much he can do. He starts fighting. A lot can be done. I can apply pressure. I can break his arm. I can do a lot of things at this point.
Let's go over this one more time. Grabs my wrist. From the inside, I trap his hand. As I step forward, I grab his wrist, bring it to my belt. If I was facing him like this, he might be able to raise his knee into my groin. Not a good thing. So when I step and turn sideways to a horse stance. This is what we call a horse stance. Good balance. Keep this tight to the belt. The pressure here is just above his elbow. I'm going to apply pressure straight down to a center point right between my legs, like this. Down he goes. He's down. Now, the way I'm standing right now gives me really good balance, okay? If he was to try and fight back, I had a little more pressure, maybe change the angle. Now he's hurt more. I can change the angle more. He's hurt more. But let's stay with the basic, right here, okay? Pain. He's hurt. Nothing he can do. Somebody call the police. We've got him. Notice that this hand that I'm holding is close to my body. Gives him no leverage at all. If it was out here, he could start moving it around. But I keep him tight. So he's got you by the wrist. to add a little realism to it, he's not just going to allow you to do what it is that I've showed you to do. You need to get his attention, hurt him first. Maybe throw a kick to the groin or stomach. As he's hurt, now he's less likely to fight back. Put him down. Now, same technique at a more realistic speed. Now, another grabbing technique would be if he grabbed the outside of my wrist. He grabs the outside. First thing you do is open the hand tight. Bring that wrist upside down like this. Palm facing yourself. Reach under the hand so your thumb is in the middle of the back of the hand. Okay? Take this one out. The thumb area. Step back. Re-grab. Now you're breaking the wrist here. The same time you're twisting, you're pulling. He should fall right in front of me. Breaks the wrist. And at this point, if you wanted to add a little more pain, you could step and change the angle and pin the elbow. Okay, he's down. I've broken his wrist and thrown him. I pull his arm out straight, keeping tension on the hand. I'm in a horse stance, which gives me excellent balance. Knees are bent, and as you can see, my left knee is right on his elbow. I can apply pressure with that knee and start breaking. Same technique at this angle. Grab the outside wrist. Hand comes upside down, palm facing yourself. Reach way under. See how the thumb is in the middle of the back of his hand? Grab it. Pull this one out the opening. Palm to palm, palm to the back of his hand. Now I'm going to step back and pull and twist. As he goes down, I'm going to keep that arm straight. Now I'm going to change the angle and apply pressure to that arm. Knee on the elbow, same time twisting this. Pressure here. Okay, let's try this at a moderate speed now. See how it goes. Grabs. Grabs. Hurt him. Take him down. Pin that arm. Break that elbow. Twist that wrist. A lot of pain involved. Let's try it full speed. Yes! Okay, at real speed. Okay, here's another outside wrist grabbing technique. First thing, open that hand tight. Very important, gives your opponent a worse grip. The thumb goes under his wrist, and you grab upward on the wrist like this, twisting at the same time. Re-grab with this way, this hand. This puts his elbow on top. At this point, all I want to do is step forward, hitting his elbow with my shoulder. A lot of body weight goes into this. Breaks pretty easy. Watch. Broken. Arm is broken now. Add a little more pain. Okay, outside wrist grab. Open the hand tight. Very important, gives your opponent a worse grip on your wrist. After that, this thumb goes under his wrist, turning it and grab. Grab with this hand here. His arm is straight. This puts his elbow on top. Needs to be here. Next thing that's going to happen is I'm going to put all of my body weight onto his elbow and hit it with my shoulder. It's going to break. Step. Hit. His arm is broken at this point. But let's say he's still resisting in some way. You can add a little more pain to that broken arm by putting your knee down on it. And he's not going anywhere. Okay, now watch this at medium speed. Try and pick up a little more on it. Grab. Don't forget what I showed you the last couple of times, couple of techniques. He's not just going to allow this. Grab. You need to hurt him. Strike. Arm is broken. If he's still resisting, add pressure to that broken arm with your knee. And he's not going anywhere. Remember, pressure, pain, he'll do anything you want. All right, now at a more realistic speed. Pain. Okay, now we've got another inside wrist grab. Grab. Remember, first thing, open that hand tight. Thumb in the middle of the back of the hand. You know, a lot of times you might be grabbed by somebody that's got a vice grip and you can't get it out of there. It's tight, okay? All you need to do is take this hand and push it towards this shoulder. Grab like this, push, and the hand will roll. Your forearm is on the back of his hand now, breaking the wrist, putting the opponent down. This is broken now. Here again, if he's still resisting, change the angle, knee on the elbow, and he's in trouble. I'm putting pressure on his wrist. The knee is on the elbow, pain in both areas. This can break. This is already broken. Okay, now we're going to try this one again. Pay attention. Simple technique, but very, very effective. Inside wrist. Open that hand tight. This hand grabs thumb in the middle of the back of the hand. You grab his hand like this. This hand pushes towards his shoulder, same time stepping in. The hand will roll. And you'll have your forearm on the back of his hand here. At this point, twist and push to a downward point right between your legs. Down he goes. His wrist is broken now, but let's say he's still fighting back, still fighting. Change the angle a little, drop the knee on the elbow. Now this is broken. Wrist broken, elbow broken. All right, same technique at full speed. Don't forget to execute that front kick to hurt him first. Okay, now at a moderate speed, don't forget that front kick to get his attention. All right, we've got another inside wrist Hapkido technique. Grab the wrist. This one's very simple. Could save your life someday. Watch carefully. Remember, open that hand tight. Real tight. Grab straight across. This will come out over, out, escaping from the thumb, back towards your shoulder. Now, I'm standing in a horse stance right now. Good balance. I'm not facing him, because this is what could happen if I was. Everything's protected now. It's escaped. Now I'm going to strike him in the neck with this bone. When my teacher did this to me, almost knocked me out. Strike. This is the end of the technique, and he should be unconscious if you hit him right. Okay, now watch again. He grabs your wrist. Open that hand tight. Very important. Grab straight. step in and turn sideways. This hand is escaping outside his thumb area, cocking it to your left shoulder. Remember, I'm standing in a horse stance and I'm sideways to him, so my groin, stomach, none of that is exposed to him, so he can't knee me or anything. At this point, I strike with this bone, hitting him on the side of the neck. This technique will knock you out. And this hand should be tight when you hit. This thumb bent. Okay, let's try it at moderate speed. Remember everything that I've showed you before. Watch carefully. Grab, grab. Take it out, cock it. You check yourself. Are you sideways? Strike the neck with this bone. Technique is over. He should be unconscious. Okay, this next technique is another inside wrist grab. There are so many places on the body to grab. We're gonna kind of stick with these insides right now. Grab my wrist, okay? Now, in Hapkido, the concept is to use your opponent's strength, not fight him. You don't wanna fight him. If he's bigger and stronger, you can't. Let's say you're a woman. You can't beat a man in strength, but if he's pulling you in this direction, for instance, there's a way out in that direction. So go with it, okay? Struck, broken wrist, down, hit. All right, watch again. Let me elaborate on what I was just saying about not using force against force, using his strength. Grab the inside wrist. For instance, if he was pulling me in this direction, the last thing I want to do is fight his strength, okay? There's a way out in that direction, so go with it. The hand escapes, striking. This gives you an opportunity to get under his arm. See how his wrist is? Now I grab his elbow and bend the wrist. It's broken. Put it against his back, step on the back of his leg, he falls. This knee here can also be used as a strike, not just a pin, so you drop it, boom. Finish. Okay, watch again. Follow along with a partner, but be careful. It does not take much pressure to break a wrist, okay? Grab the inside wrist. Remember, he's pulling you in this direction. I don't want to fight. I want to go with it. Use his strength. Go. Hand escapes. Elbow strike. This gives me a chance to get under his arm. Grab the elbow. See his wrist is bent? Broken. Put it on his back, step on the back of his leg, down he goes. He's got a broken wrist at this point, and he's landed right between your legs. I'm now standing in a horse stance, good balance. This knee not only acts as a pinning technique, but it's also a strike. Bam, bam. Okay, let's try the same technique at moderate speed. Don't forget to do a strike first. He's pulling me, okay? I hurt him. This hand escapes. Under his arm, pin and break. Elbow down between your legs. This knee is a strike, remember. Bam, bam. Okay, let's try this one at full speed now. Watch how I go with his force. Okay, we're gonna try this at full speed. Watch how it flows. Okay, in this wrist technique, inside wrist grab again. You grab his wrist just straight like this. This hand goes on the side of his elbow. You step with your right foot, same time twisting, pushing up on the elbow. See how the arm bends? Now I'm going to step through. At this point, he's in a lot of trouble. Here, you're going to pull this hand right here towards your belt and push this one down. He will land right between your legs. You pin that arm and then strike. All right, now watch again. This one's a little more advanced. Takes a little more, so pay real close attention. Grabs the wrist. I grab his wrist. I step with my right foot, grab the side of his elbow. All the time I'm twisting. See how the arm bends? Now I step through, bending his arm, pulling it tight, elbows up, okay? At this point, this hand, I'm in a horse stance now. I'm gonna drag him around my leg. This hand is gonna go to a center point between my legs. This one's gonna push. Down he falls. His arm is bent, and I'm pinning his arm on the ground, breaking his own wrist on the ground. Now all that's left to do is finish. Okay, now from this angle, take a good close look at his wrist. I'm pushing down on his elbow, which is breaking his wrist. He's pinned, he's not going anywhere. All that's left to do is finish it. Okay, this time, let's look at this at a moderate speed. Pay close attention. Grabbed, under, bend, down, pin, punch. Okay, full speed. Now this technique is pretty nasty, or it can be. It's up to you, however you want to use it. I'm going to show you the options here. Another inside wrist grab. Grab it. Grab the wrist underneath the elbow. Step tight, straightening his arm. Step under his arm. Slide this hand down to this one. Break his arm on your shoulder. It's broken now. Go under the arm. See how I have his hands? Twist. And pull around to your belt. He's fall. Broken wrist, broken elbow. Add a little more pain. Notice how I'm holding his wrist. My thumbs are in the middle of the back of his hand. This is how I have it. Twist, his wrist is broken. You've already broken his elbow on your shoulder. Any kind of resisting? Knee goes down on the elbow. When the pain starts, he doesn't fight anymore. Okay, same technique. Watch again for the details. I'll do it slowly. Grabs the wrist. I grab his wrist underneath his elbow. Twist. Arm is straight, locked. I step under, slide my hands down so that my thumbs are in the middle of the back of his hand. Pulling down, breaking his arm. His elbow just broke. I go under his arm, step back, twist and pull to my belt. Pull that arm straight. Change the angle, add pain. Pain to that already broken elbow, and there'll be no more fight left in him. No more fighting at all. Okay, moderate speed now. Pay close attention. At this point, I'm in a horse stance. Look where his arm is. Broken. Thrown. Pin. All right, full speed. All right, let's go back to the outside wrist grab, okay? This one's a little difficult, so pay close attention. All right, grab, upward, twist, step, chop. Here you are, you've just knocked him out again. This one look familiar? We just did it a little while ago. Knee, put your foot down, but kind of behind yourself. Pull his head towards your belt, push this hand this way, it'll twist him. Down he goes. Okay, watch again. I'll do it relatively slow. Watch all of the moves now. Outside wrist grab. Under, grab up, up, twist, step, chopping the neck. Remember this technique a little earlier? It's gonna knock him out. At this point, knee, step behind yourself, pull his neck towards your belt and push up on this arm. And over he goes. Finishing blow is up to you. Watch again very closely. I'm going to point out the most difficult part of this particular technique, and that's the twisting of his body that makes him fall, the one that's you're throwing him. When I get to this point after I've chopped him and I'm over here, this has to be pulled down and towards your belt this way. This one is going this way. This twisting motion is what causes him to go over. Okay, keep that in mind. Okay, ready for the technique. Grabs the outside wrist. Okay, up, twist, chop, knee. I'm gonna step behind myself. Twisting, pulling, finishing blow, up to you. All right, let's try one, full speed. Okay, we're going to move into double hand wrist grabs. Okay, this one's pretty easy. If you recall, one of the other techniques that we did just on the outside wrist, with both hands you're going to grab the same way, under and up, twisting, putting him like this. See how his arms have twisted? To make things worse, I'm going to front kick him in the stomach, which will bend him over even farther. Then step straight back and pull downward, which will put him on his face. And at this point, you can pretty much do whatever you want. All right, now watch again. Double-handed wrist grab. As soon as you grabbed, don't forget, open those hands tight. That gives your opponent a worse grip. Okay, now, hands go under this way. Grab the wrists up and twist. Basically, you're making a circle. Twist, see what it does to him? At this point, with a front kick, kick him in the stomach, which will bend him over even farther. After the kick, step back, pull down. He should land right in front of you, and the finishing blow is up to you. So many things you can do. All right, without a partner, watch what I'm doing with my hands and what I do with his wrists. I'm basically gonna make a circle. I'm grabbing up and twisting his wrists like this, okay? Once again, grabbing up, twist, bring his arms apart, front kick, step back, pull down, finishing blow. All right, this one at moderate speed. All right, full speed this time. Watch what happens to him. All All right, here we go into another double wrist defense. This one, a little more difficult, involves a kick to the leg. Grab the wrists. All right. This one, this hand here is going to go around and over on top of his wrist this way. I'm going to step to the left, and this hand is going to go under his elbow, and I'm going to lock his arm like this. Now, with this foot, my right foot, I'm going to kick him hard right in the shin. Bam, like this. The effect it'll give is to treetop him. Put him right down in front of you, because you're going to break that leg and kick his feet out from underneath him while pulling him in this direction with this arm. Okay? Watch. One, two, three. All right, watch it from this angle. Double wrist grab. Left hand over on top. Left foot steps. Right hand under his elbow, locking the arm. Right foot is going to kick the shin, the outside shin, this way. Same time, push, pull. Same time you make impact with the kick. Here we go. All right, here we go at a moderate speed. Remember what I told you before, watch carefully. Grabbed, on top, elbow, kick, pull. Here we go at full speed. All right, we're going to do another double wrist grab. This one involves a little bit of circular motion to escape and sweeping. Watch closely. Don't forget, always important to open those hands tight. Now right here, just make a circle and push. Step in, hook, step back, kick. Down he goes. All right, watch again now. The opponent grabs, hands open tight, very important. Circle, push the hands out of the way. Step in, hook, with this leg, kick as you step back. Down he goes. All right, one more time, watch closely. Double wrist grab. Open the hands tight and make a circle. Push the hands to the side. Step in between his legs and hook. Step back, kick, pull down. All right, we've got another double outside wrist grab for you. Pay close attention. This one's relatively easy. Remember this grab? How you twist from previous ones? Twist. Step forward, hook the foot, and then just push forward with your knee. Down he goes, finishing blow. Up to you. All right, watch again. Pay close attention. Grab under, like you're grabbing a hold of a baseball bat. Twist it. You remember this one from previous ones. Step, hook the foot close. Bend the knee forward. He'll go down. Finishing blow is up to you. All right, moderate speed this time. Watch carefully. He grabs, double baseball bat. Twist. Step forward, hook that leg. As you push, this will break his knee. Lean forward, bend the knee, he goes down. Finishing blow is up to you. All right, now we're going to move into lapel grabbing. Go ahead, grab. All right, with my right hand, I'm going to grab his lapel first on this particular technique. Notice my thumb? This thumb is going to go in his windpipe right here and apply pressure, which will bend him over like this. Sorry. All right, this hand grabs his shoulder. Step, twist, kick. Down he goes. This knee can also be a strike. When somebody grabs you on this particular technique, the right hand grabs his lapel. Notice my thumb. It's going to go in his throat right here. Okay? Pushing with the thumb, pulling with this one, step. Now this is important, to push him back and off balance. I'll show you why in a minute. Kick, knee strike, punch. Here again, I grab his lapel with my right hand. Notice my thumb, it's going to go in his throat. I'll explain why right now that this is this important. Without this thumb, if I were just to grab him and I step and go and try and kick him, both of us right now have exactly the same leverage. All he has to do is push and he can do it back to me. This is a matter of the stronger man wins. This thumb is what gives you the leverage. Now he's bent over. Kick. Down he goes. Finishing blow. All right, moderate speed now. Pay close attention. Shoulder, lapel, thumb, twist, kick, knee. All right, watch again, moderate speed. Grab, grab, thumb, twist, kick, knee strike. All right, here's another lapel grab. Right hand grabs over like this. Notice how I've got a hold of his hand? This is how I want to grab. Grab over. Turn it completely upside down so the little finger is on top. Pointing straight up. Too far is no good. Not enough is no good. Completely straight up. Step back and off to the right. This gives you some stability and balance here. This thumb goes under your opponent's thumb, these fingers on his wrist. Now, keep this tight against your chest because you're going to be pushing with your chest. This is going to help bend this wrist. You're going to push down with these fingers, up with this thumb. Broken wrist, finish. All right, look at it close from this angle. Pay attention to how I'm grabbing. Over, thumb goes here, grab the hand. Turn it completely upside down. Little finger on top, not too little, not too far. Completely on top. Thumb, under his thumb. Fingers, on his wrist. Step back and off to the right. Push, broken wrist. All right, watch again, this lapel grab. Right hand grabs over. Turn it completely upside down, little finger on top. Step back and off to the right. Not straight back, you have no balance straight back. Step off to the right. Thumb under your opponent's thumb. Fingers on top the wrist. Pushing with your chest, pushing down here, pushing up with this thumb. Broken. All right, now watch again. Right hand grabs over. Turn it completely upside down. Little finger has to be on top, tight against the chest. Left thumb under his thumb. Fingers on the wrist. At this point, once you've got a hold of him, okay, the thumb here is pushing up. These fingers pushing down. You're leaning forward with your chest. Step back. Now, apply pressure.
Okay.
All right, now we're going to do it a little more moderate speed. Grab. Grab over. Turn it upside down. Thumb under. Apply pressure down. All right, here's another lapel grab. This one's a little more difficult, but very effective. All right, both hands grab at the same time, like this. This finger, keep open. Step with your right foot and go low. Now with the bone on this finger, push this way and this way. This way and this way. Now he's up on his toes. This hurts bad. At this point, I step under. Twist, this is breaking his wrist. His wrist is broken. The fall has probably hurt him bad. But if he's still got any fight in him, remember the pin that I showed you earlier, where you step and apply pressure on the elbow. You can break it if you want, or just pin him. All right, watch again now. Grab. Both hands, same time. Left index finger open, like this. Step with the right foot, turning his wrist right here upside down. Now remember, with this finger, you're going to roll it towards you, finger up, just like you'd be poking yourself in the eye. See? This way, up. This is what it does. It puts him on his toes and in an awful lot of pain. He's not going to fight back. Then step under. See how I've got his hand? Thumbs in the middle of the back of the hand. Twist and pull around to your belt. His wrist is already broken. If you want it, still want to hurt him more, pin him. Remember that one earlier. Knee on the elbow, break. All right, this one we'll try at moderate speed. I'll still explain it to you on the way through. Pay close attention. Don't forget about this bone pressure. Very important. Otherwise, realize when you take that first step without it, you're vulnerable. He's going to hit you. Raise your foot. He's going to hurt me. Okay? This way you need it like this. He can't do that now. All right? All right, moderate speed this time. All right, step. Bone pressure. Step through. Twist, pull to the belt. Pull that arm straight. Step, step. Pin that elbow. Break it if you want. All right, prior to any type of fighting, a lot of times there's pushing involved. If somebody was to come up and push you on the chest, here's another technique. Watch it slowly, pay attention. He does it open-handed, like this. As he does, you kind of step back and go with it, okay? Keep it tight, tight to your chest, open-handed. It's important that the wrist is twisted, like this, because if it's straight, he's pretty strong, he can fight back, but twisted, he's very weak. So twist it, keep it to your chest, and then just lean forward and he'll go down. All right, watch again now. As the push comes towards you, step away from it. Keep it to your chest and turn it slightly to the right so it's at an angle. Remember, if it's straight like this, he's strong, he can fight back. It needs to be twisted. And it also needs to be tight to the chest, because your chest leaning forward into it is what's going to do the damage. Keep it tight, push. Down he goes. All right, this one will be at moderate speed, and as soon as the hand gets close enough, you need to start moving. Moderate speed, step back, push. Everybody, I'd like to thank you for joining me. I hope you've enjoyed your lesson. A few things I'd like to go over, though. For real, in a real street fight, all of these techniques I have actually used for real or a variation of it. So I know they work. And one thing I'd like to point out is the biggest enemy in a real life situation is fear. What conquers fear? Confidence conquers fear, and you gain confidence by doing a technique over and over and over. It's the repetition that leads to success. So, don't just do something a couple of times. Do it over and over and until you feel real confident about it. Practice with a friend. See how good you can get. If ever in doubt, refer back to the video. I wish you the best of luck in your training.